This video is just a quick introduction to how to create Google Forms if you don't already know how to do that. Google Forms are another free application, and they do some very specific and specialized things that really help in creating an escape room. So I like to start with a blank form. And you can change the colors and all of that stuff later. Don't start with that. Always do that at the end. But it always starts like this. So you would title it whatever you want to title it. And then right now it's got a multiple choice question on here that you could create. And so you would type your question here. And then you would type your options here, just like in a regular multiple choice question. Here, you can require the question, meaning students cannot submit the form unless they have for sure answered this question. And if you have several multiple choice questions in a row, then you would want to hit duplicate, so that you could very quickly just change these things and it would still be multiple choice. If you want to add any kind of other question, you would click add. Then there's a down arrow next to multiple choice and you have all of these. This is a short answer. This is like an essay answer question. You have checkboxes. Checkboxes are like multiple choice questions, except that students can click more than one answer in a checkbox. You have a drop-down menu, which is just like multiple choice. It's just another way to look at it. They put all of your choices into a box that the students have to hit a down arrow button to look at the choices. You can file upload questions, which I haven't tried yet, but they say it works seamlessly and really well. And then this multiple choice grid, you can set up like a matching. This can be like a matching question. Linear scales are like when you want students to say how well they like something. For instance, did you like the short story Sound of Thunder? Then the linear scale will say, you know, from 0 to 10 or 0 to 5, and you label the scale the way you want to label it. I have never used checkbox grid, so I'm not sure what I would use that for. Okay, so that's just the type of questions. Then, one thing you need to know how to do to make escape room questions is this add a section. When you click that, it adds a section, and they have to finish section one before they can move on to the next section. Instead of seeing a long form, this means they would just see this first part, and then they would hit a next button, and that would take them to the next section. And sections are going to be really important in module 4. Then you could also add just text. If you click that, there's a title where you can add a title, and then you can add some more text if you don't want to ask a question yet, but you need to tell them some things in a form. And then this button right here, you would add an image, and it's just like you always add images. It would put your image in here. I'll go ahead and do that very quickly just to show you, because you have some, let's say I'm just going to do that to just quickly show you how to do that. And then right here, you can left align it, center align, right align it. You can change it. You can remove it. I like to put it in the center. You can also, if you click on it, you can make the image smaller or bigger. And then the same thing happens if you want to add a video. You can add videos into forms. And so if you wanted to add a video, you would click this button and upload your video. basically, this is how you create a form. Then you would want to hit the settings tab and answer all these questions. Here's general. You want to answer these first. Then you want to answer presentation questions. You can type an ending message right here. And if it is a quiz, you would want to turn that on. That's how you're able to add answers so that Google Form would grade your quiz for you. However, you're not going to make escape rooms a quiz, so you would keep that off for escape rooms. Okay, then this is how you make it pretty, and you make it look however you want to make it look. You click the artist palette, and the first thing you can do is either choose a header or you can upload a header. So I usually will upload a header that goes with the theme of my puzzle or the theme of my escape room. So the header ends up right there, and it's the header that creates the colors. You have a few choices. These colors right here are the banners and the tabs. So watch, as I click red, that changes to red and the background colors change. If I click green, the tabs change to green and the background, etc. Let's say I like this color the best, then you have a few background choices down here to choose from. And then you have font style. There's not very many. You can have basic, you can have decorative, looks like that. You can have formal, which looks like that. Or you can have playful, which looks like that. I try to pick all of these things to go with the theme of either my puzzle or my escape room. Oh, one last thing. Sorry, I was about to hit stop. One last thing. This is how you share it with your students. You have to hit the send button. When you do, you're going to choose to give them a link, or you might choose to embed it, depending on where you're putting your form. Usually for me, it's a link. Every once in a while, I embed it. And then I like to click this right here, which forms will shorten the link. So I shorten the link, and then I copy the link, and then I share that with my students.